I'm here downtown Toronto at the Surrey Place Centre, which is next to Women's College Hospital. We're going to be going inside and meeting Deanna, who works at the coffee shed, and the partners in her program. So we're here in the coffee shed at the Surrey Place Center, the coffee shed. And how long have you guys been working at the coffee shed?
I'm working now 5 years.
And this is your best friend, Mei Li?
Me is my partner. This is my team.
There's 10 partners.
Yeah, 10 partners.
Okay. And I hear you guys interviewed Deanna and you chose her to work here.
Yes. Our foreign partnership who interviewed her.
Cool. And was she much better than the other candidates? Oh, we can't say that. Do you think you made a good choice?
Yes.
We did one compost.
Compost. I hear that you've had some TV crews in here talking with you about the compost.
Yes.
Andrew is the compost expert here.
Yeah? I am.
Fantastic. Can you take me on a tour of the compost facility?
Of course you can. Sure.
Fantastic.
Of course
you
can.
Okay. So is this today's compost bucket so far?
Yes, it is.
Not full, so we're just going to do a demonstration. Yes. Oh, what do we hear?
We have worm poo.
Wow, this is worm poo.
Yeah.
We make it
chow chow. What's chow chow? Like little chickies hatching?
Yeah. That smells stink.
Let's see.
If you put that in your...
They don't smell too bad. They smell like dirt.
If you put it's that in dirt, your garden,
I guarantee you, garden. Your crops will grow 100% better. If you put one of our worm poos in it.
You know, I was at Deanna's house, and she has this grapevine that was dead, and she put these worm poo balls in it, and now it's alive again.
Yeah.
That's wonderful stuff. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's check out the composting.
Sure. Okay.
Joanna.
Please.
Okay. Hey, Joanna. Just right here.
Just outside?
Yep.
I remember CBC came and filmed you guys. And
yep, we did.
I remember you being out in the parking lot with the compost bin.
Yep. Me and Aldin, another one of our partners.
Great. So there's 10 of you all together?
10? 10.
10, great. And how long have you been here?
And one trainee.
One trainee. So that's the newest person on board?
Yes.
Okay. I'm here?
I'm actually one of the newest. I'm actually celebrating my second year, December 13th.
Oh, there is the famous compost shed.
Yep, that's our famous compost bin.
That's excellent. And it has its own little vent on it.
Yep.
With Willy Wiggler. Wow, who painted
it's
that?
Ventilation, I did.
Vermicompost.
It's ventilation because it's really hot in there.
Yeah. Generates its own heat.
You want to see a show, watch Andrew. He's scared of bugs.
I hear you don't like bees, Andrew.
No.
Wow, it's a lot of fruit flies. Look at that. There's the rake, so it's insulated with styrofoam for the winter.
Yep.
Is it nice and warm in there in the winter?
Oh, yes. It's steaming. So we come out and just move it around. See, he's still standing there because he's scared of the bugs.
Oh, even the... You don't like the fruit flies even, huh?
No.
No. And so then you pull it out from the bottom?
No, we actually dig it out. We take the top layer off, put it onto a tarp, and then all the stuff in the bottom is the compost. We just scrape it out.
How often do you harvest it?
Every 6 months. We might have to get another bin because this is going really well. And given the garbage strike that's going on right now, this is very beneficial. So we have 8,000 red wiggler worms in here, but they're all at the bottom of this bin because they don't like light.
So they don't get hurt when you chop it up
Pretty much, no. You have to pop some holes in it because it needs lots of air.
Okay.
Okay, Andrew, you're going to stand and look pretty?
Mom, what do you need to do, Andy?
Andrew's working on his fear, his fears of bugs.
Coffee, banana peels, coffee filters.
All the staff in this building drop it off.
Yep, they usually put like scraps of fruit, vegetables, their coffee, tea bags.
Good.
All of it is in there.
So 250 people, how many of them do you think pay attention to the program?
Everyone.
Really? So how often does that get filled?
It gets half filled every day.
Half filled every day. Yeah. That's excellent.
We dump it every single day.
Yeah, and is there supposed to be sticks in there?
Yes, sticks sometimes are help with the aeration in the in the thing. So it's like we put newspaper in because it keeps the smell down.
Okay.
And worms can eat this because there's a vegetable print, so we got to be careful with the ink that's in the paper.
Oh.
So it's vegetable. So it's fine.
So the Toronto Star is safe.
Yep, Toronto Star and the Metro, all of it's pretty much vegetable-based inks now, so you don't have to worry about chemicals.
And then little shreds of plastic, like the Chiquita, the Dole banana stuff.
We pick that out.
Oh, yeah?
That just gets picked out or it gets to the bottom of the bin and we grab it.
Like, so when you roll the poo balls at that
stage?
This
is an experiment. They say this is biodegradable.
Okay.
So we like to put these things in just to see how long it takes. This has been in 2 weeks and hasn't even done anything yet, so... The biodegradable, usually the worms can't eat that kind of stuff, but we try it. Just like this stuff.
Have you had any of those new compostable plastic cups that are theoretically made
from
cornstarch or anything?
We had one in here and it didn't break down for like months.
Huh.
So what it would do in a landfill, if it was covered, I don't think it would break down.
Because it doesn't have oxygen in a landfill, right?
That's exactly what the issues are. That's why I come out here and poke holes and move the stuff around and get oxygen through.
That is great. So you're able to experiment with theoretically compostable products, see if they actually do.
Exactly. Because we purchase these cups here, and they're more expensive, so we want to see if they actually do work.
Yeah. So the most important thing is to reduce the consumption, because even the stuff they say is compostable often
is not.
Is not.
Absolutely. We've tried a lot of bags, so this has turned into a bit of an experiment as well. So this is a big science project. So it's all good stuff. Because people get plants. Sometimes people bring stuff from home to us.
It's like a bird's nest.
No, you never know.
Now those strawberry containers, those old-fashioned ones, they should break
paper,
down pretty
they do.
Good.
They're
that's
great.
Just straight up pressed.
Yep.
Fiber.
Absolutely, they're great, and this will break down really well. It will be done pretty soon.
So, Andrew, you're at the cutting edge of science here.
Yep.
Running scientific experiments.
Working on his phobia.
Working on your phobia of fruit flies and everything else, huh? You have to come out here with a beekeeper's net over your head.
Beekeeper.
Hopefully, Deanna won't make you start raising your own honey here.
No,
hopefully not.
This was tough enough sell at the beginning. Tell them we're gonna do composting. But now they're all great. They all love it.
So this was your brainchild, huh?
Yes.
So we're here in an urban environment surrounded by hospital, some trees.
Government buildings.
Government buildings, parking lot. No excuse for this to not be done anywhere at all.
Absolutely.
Okay, so the coffee shed is only one aspect of an overarching program,
So we have coffee shed, which is here at Surrey Place. We have coffee shed at JVS. We have a coffee shed at New College U of T. And then we have a lemon allspice cookery. And with all four businesses, there's 54 partners that are supported, which is the umbrella of Common Ground Cooperative.
Okay.
And the Common Ground Cooperative is who I get paid through. It's the charitable status, the funding, the board of directors, and all the administrative support towards these four businesses. So we're called what's called a social purpose enterprise.
Okay.
That's the best way to explain who we are and what we are, and then around that is just all the dynamics of what we do.